Hello my friends, in today's really cool video we're gonna talk about how to do proper setup to color grade in HDR. Now, before we start, we're gonna require two things in order for you to actually successfully color grade in HDR. One thing is the decklink card. And the reason why you need decklink card is to properly output clean signal. If you want to find out more information about it, I'm going to place link right now right above so you can go ahead and watch my dedicated video. The second thing we're going to need is actually a proper reference display that supports HDR. So it cannot be emulation. It cannot be one of those lower tier, the 300, 400, 600, whatever, nits, very cheap TVs that don't really deliver that number. It's got to be higher end monitor or TV that actually can handle it. So the first thing I want to do, I want to change resolution of my project to 4K or UHD, depending on whatever you're working with. Okay, so let's click like that and click save. And we can see nothing really going on. Everything's the same, but now we have basically 4K environment. So let's go back to the settings again. And now I'm going to go to the color management. And in the color management, we're going to do a few adjustments in order to properly set up our project. Let's go to the color science. And we're going to change default color science to DaVinci YRGB color managed. Okay, I'm going to click over here. And now we have selection where we can choose Resolve Color Management Preset. If you don't want to use preset and you're more advanced and you know maybe something I don't, go to the custom settings and dial your own things. However, in this case, we have two presets that perfect match for us. HDR P3 Broadcast and HDR Rec 2020. Now, depending on your monitor, whether your monitor supports P3 color space, or like in my case, my monitor supports 95% of Rec 2020. So I'm going to be color grading and demonstrating for Rec 2020. So I'm going to click that, and we're halfway done. So now what we're going to do? Now I'm going to select output color space. And in the output color space, I'm going to go down and I'm going to select Rec 2020 ST2084. ST2084 is PQ Gamma. So we're going to be working with Rec 2020 PQ 1000 nits. Again, this is very important. Be sure not to jump ahead more than what your monitor can handle. My monitor can handle 1300 nits. So color grading for 1000 nits is the perfect sweet spot for me. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to select right over here, HDR mastering for 1000 nits. Okay, perfect. Now, since I'm going to be color grading for Dolby Vision, I'm going to select enable Dolby Vision, just like this. Dolby Vision version, we're going to leave 4.0. And mastering display, we're going to do 1000 nit BT2020 D65, which stands for the white point, PQ full. Okay. And now we're going to click save. And something happened, but not quite exactly. Now, another thing, it's very important, I want to demonstrate to you, is how to set up scopes. By default, you're probably going to have normal setup, just like this. However, now we're going to need to set up our scopes specifically for HDR. And thankfully, in DaVinci Resolve 17, we have that option. So if we're going to click three little dots over here and select waveform scale style, we can go all the way down to HDR ST2084, aka PQ HLG. Okay. So we're going to click over here, and now we have HDR scopes. And I'm going to come back to that in 1 second. So let me move this for really quick. So now we're almost there. However, it's very important. Do not rely on the GUI image. So graphic user interface over here. Once you're going to set up completely for HDR, this picture over here is no longer going to be accurate. And I'm going to show it to you in 1 second. So let's go back to our settings. And this time, let's go again back to the master settings. And now in the master settings, I'm going to select for my reference monitor, I'm going to select UHD 2160. So we're going to match our timeline resolution. Data levels, I'm going to set to full. Video bit depth, I'm going to scale to 12-bit. And I'm going to enable HDR metadata over HDMI because my reference monitor, my Asus ProArt, is HDMI monitor. If you guys want to learn more about DaVinci Resolve, check out my in-depth insider knowledge tutorial. It's specifically oriented for people who just starting to work with DaVinci Resolve all the way to intermediate users. And I'm basically covering the entire workflow with DaVinci Resolve from very basic introduction all the way to delivery, how to edit, how to do sound editing, how to do color grading, and final delivery. It's a really nice course. Check it out. I'll put links in the description below. So now we have everything set up over here, and let's click save. And nothing really happens to this image. However, on the reference monitor, now we have a proper image. Unfortunately, I cannot record this reference monitor because I only have the output card. I don't have recording card to show you difference. However, I'm going to put side by side what you see here, this clip, and what proper HDR look like compared to this. Okay, so now what I'm going to do now, I'm going to really quick put my HDR Blackmagic lot on it. Origami HDR Blackmagic, and I'm going to do something like this one. Okay, and if I'm going to go before and after over here, we can see a very little difference. However, the difference is pretty significant on HDR monitor. So let me do copy and paste something over here. And again, we can see really, really significant difference. Now let's try to do with the red camera. So again, I'm going to put a lot on the red camera and we can see how it looks in the GUI compared to what it looks like with HDR. And you probably should have HDR monitor in order to correctly see this video. Otherwise, it may not appear correct, but hopefully YouTube will do the justice and show it to you accurately. Okay, so let's do same thing over here. Okay, and let's do a little adjustments. Let's add a little bit information in the shadows and let's drop a little bit of highlights. Now, I promised I'm going to come back to scope. So let me get this clip over here. Let me copy the LUT from the previous clip and let me show it to you what looks like on the scopes. Because we're color grading for 1000 nits, watch what's going to happen if I'm going to try to go above it. We can't because our project is basically limiting to go above it. And once you go above it, everything just blows up and doesn't look correctly. So this is how you set up your project to work for HDR. If you're interested in HDR workflow, I have a fantastic premium tutorial coming up on my Origami Color website. It's going to be available in about a week. I'm going to put a link in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.